Okay. Let's see, I gotta grab. Stream's already full of funkers. What's up? Just making a little tweet. Alright. Real quick. We've got to go over the usual bullshit. You know, how is the music? How is my voice?
Simulation.
I can't hear what people think of the music versus my voice. I'm just getting so many comments. Hello.
Hello, everyone. Hello. Ah, thank you for millions of dollars so I can make the evil rhythm game Friday Night Funkin.
Music is a bit loud. Okay. All right. It's been a while since I streamed. And I think it's good to thank you, everybody, unironically, you know, for the support for the game. Jokes aside, you know, like, it's been very nice to have everybody's support. I just want to do a little stream. Oh, one guy said it wasn't loud, the music. Okay, I'm turning music back up then. I don't know what the fuck's right or wrong anymore with the music. Oh, somebody said it still needs to be turned down. Okay, you know what? I'm going to get the music to a good volume for me. Right. Audio output's turning. Okay. All right. Back to where we were at. You know, a lot of the updates on the Kickstarter have been ironic. If not just downright antagonistic, getting people in trouble by cussing in the updates and stuff, but you know, like unironically, this is one of the few times, you know, you're just hearing me say thank you. Like I said, now I can't hear it. Man, I just can't get this shit right. Oh, goodness. I wish I... Here, wait. I'm going to listen to my own stream for a second. All right. There, I think... This is a good volume. This is a good volume. I can hear it through my own headphones. But yeah, just, you know... Damn it, we're just getting so distracted with the audio levels. We can't hear shit. You fucking liar, I just heard my own stream. I'm gonna put me off my music again and check it again. Hey, I just heard my own stream, it sounds fine. You liars. I know it sounds good, I just checked it. Alright, enough of this shit. thank you for supporting the game. It's pretty crazy. We're working around the clock on crazy shit. It's been very stressful, but like, it's much appreciated. And you know, it feels nice that like I don't have to twiddle my fingers and ask friends for favors anymore. you know, in a while, once, you know, we have all this stuff, we pay the Kickstarter fees, all that, we can, you know, we can actually give our friends money they deserve. And that will be great. That will be great that I'm not just asking what somebody can or can't do for free. And I like making cartoons, so, you know, I'm already getting to that. So, yeah, I don't even know what to say. And it's thank you, that's what I'll say. Thank you.
Thank you.
It's much appreciated. It's also nerve-wracking, because it's just like, goddamn, we got a lot of stuff we gotta do now. And now everybody's expecting something amazing! I just wanted to make a funny cartoon game! Anyway, enough of that shit. Thank you, everybody. Let's get on to the Week 7 asset review. So we have the Tank Man. Oh, that's the Watchtower. I gotta unlock all layers. So we have the Tank Man, which, you know, you guys have seen before. Alright, I'm getting nervous. Alright. The music is a good volume. Could arguably even be a little louder. So we have the Tank Man, which everybody saw months ago and traced. Thank you all for that. Thanks for tracing it. So, you know, I feel like his stuff's even a little janky, but it looks good. Take his layers off. We can pull them apart. We go into this. I didn't layer any of the lines or stuff. So, like, I drew the lines, as you can kind of see, because you see where this purple is? That's where I took the line, selected it, made it purple, but I filled it. So now there basically is no original line art anymore. But hey, I don't give a shit. There's not too much to this. I mean, you guys have seen it. You guys have traced it. It's Tank Man. This little guy back here. We have the rolling tank that passes in the background. As Jeff made a lot of fun of me for doing. I created the original art, animated it on multiple layers. I did the stupid thing of breaking it all down into single layers. Then I put like this gradient on top of it. Well, not even a gradient, I just put yellow and blurred it as a movie clip on top of it. Then took the raw art and masked it in, so that way it would have a sunset effect on it. I have found out how gradients work in Flash now. So, I understand now how this is stupid. Anybody who's watching who's better at Flash than I am will understand that this is ass backwards, but I don't give a shit. Fucking sue me. The way this was originally animated was the top part, like, it was originally just that, this, like, Chassis was a piece, Steve was a piece, and then the bottom part here, you know, like, the tank treads move, the wheels kind of wiggle, the, like, cylinders, the chassis kind of goes up and down and vibrates, and Steve kind of moves around in place. We'll get the fuck out of here. But anyway, that's that. I kind of wanted to make him bob more, but we ran out of time. You guys just wanted the dang level. So that's him. He moves in code. Next we have the smoke, which you won't see be animated right here. Oh, I fucked up Captain's hand, and now he's all doing weird shit. The smoke isn't animated in the timeline, because it's a movie clip. I animated the smoke completely, like, 2D, like, by hand. It's kind of janky. Just goes from one frame, just kind of, like, try to make it as smooth as possible. And then what I did was to make it look less like crap. In the final thing, you know, I turned it into a movie clip, I blurred it. Cam takes those assets, and it kind of, it feels a bit more smoke-ish in the final version. Holy shit. People are donating. What the hell? What the fuck? Some dude named Christian918777 said, "Hey, Dave, you are one hell of an artist and you do amazing work. Keep up the great work and also keep up the amazing work on Friday Night Funkin'," and donated $100. What the fuck? Oh my god. There's another donation that I will read, and it's equally as important because all donations are nice. Fewey Fish donated $1.26. I said, "I love your art and animation so much. Keep going also. Thanks for believing in Pico Made Supremacy." Every day. Every day. And I will kind of do like a lore review of the week. Won't give away too much. We're going to keep the stream short, guys. We're going to keep the stream short. But, you know, just something fun. And there'll be more streams later. I want to play Smash Brothers with people. I want to play Metal Gear Solid Rising Revengeance on hard mode on stream. I think that'd be fun, just to relax. Will the Gold Mario Amiibo be in Friday Night Funkin'? That person, that's a flashback and a half. That's a reference to one of my earlier cartoons. That's a true Phantom Arcade fan. You sicko. All right. Let's keep this going. I want to move this along. So we have all these tank men in the foreground. And look, it's an illusion. There's not a tank man staying there. It's just the tip of his head that undulates and shit. Did the same thing I did for the tank in the background. I went insane and did like these special lighting effects that makes it sort of look like they have sunlight cast onto them. This guy over here is just a duplicate of this guy. Lol. We wanted to do like a cool foreground element, kind of like how all the classic Newgrounds console games have. So these guys, the way that like they kind of parallax in the foreground, I think is really fun and cool. It kind of makes you feel like an audience is watching. Back here, we have Skittles after he's become a soldier for the enemy team. He's dancing. He originally was just static, but we got him dancing. He's bobbing along to the beat with his sniper rifle back there. just enjoying the music in between phone calls of his dad trying to teach him about the bird and the bees. Here we have the special, unique girlfriend being held at gunpoint. It's the regular girlfriend animation, but we have the tankman bobbing on both sides. And the first time I ever leaked it, I didn't have Steve drawn yet. So, in the initial leak, you'll see that there's just two Captain Johns on both sides. But it was intended for there to be Steves, plus there were meant to be Steves who die in Song 3, but I wasn't able to find the time. Oh man, that guy sure likes posting that, let's say hypothetically, copy-paste. The song is speaking so sensually. The feelings of being held at gunpoint as a 19-year-old. Nothing gets the blood pumping quite like your life being on the line. Can I sync her up with the music that's playing right now? So yeah, so if people in the chat are commenting, yeah, see, that is sort of where it gets weird. Like, you can say, like, WTF, there's multiple Captain Johns and multiple Steves. But, you see, in Tank Man 2, we see that, like, what's that software? It's Flash CS4. So in Tank Man 2, at the eatery, we see that there's multiple, you know, their armor is duplicates. Okay, but where is week 7 on Spotify? Search it, bitch. It's on there. Oh, by the way, I don't know if anybody's being like sarcastic or not, but like week 7 is out. If you're saying like what week 7 in the chat, maybe you're kidding. But yeah, no, that's out. It's on Newgrounds. It's only on Newgrounds. It'll come to itch in a bit. Listen. Here's the deal with this shit. One guy said what? It's out? Are you kidding? Listen, so as we're gonna review here, there's the uh-oh sensor that'll be in the game at some point. Oh fuck, that's loud. I'm gonna turn that off so I don't hear that. Oh, we still hear it.
Look who it is, your sexually
ambiguous angry little friend. Yep. So like these animations of Tankman talking here, watch, we're gonna see the scroller go through. You know, I moved each head, each hand, each arm. They're very large animations. We had to come up with workarounds on how to get them in the full game. What is it, the dude spamming ugly and boring? That's what your mom said about you. Shut the fuck up. If you don't like it, you can leave, bitch. I know that dude's probably just joking because I've seen that dude around in the chat. He's just a little ironic shitposter. What are you saying? Uh-oh, leak. It's not a leak. This is out. It's out, you dickheads. Hey, this stream is pissing me off. Listen. Fucking hell. I can't even see what the hell this dude, that man's chat's saying. Any chance of you and Corey playing Persona on Oni Plays? I'm reading like the most random things. I don't think... Here's the thing. So I wanted to play Trapped on Oni Plays, and Trapped is a cool PS2 game. And we started playing it, and like, fucking Chris was sitting there, and he like, it looked like he was slipping into a coma. Like on Oni Plays, you have to pick, when you're playing a game and having fun with friends, you gotta pick a game that's fun for your friends. Trapped on PS2 is a fucking awesome game. Deception 3 or whatever the fuck it is. But like, if your friend isn't into the game you're playing, then it's not really fun. And I don't think that like, a turn-based RPG is with like long visual novel segments is very fun for the whole family. That's kind of like something you play by yourself, really. Basically, I took that question too seriously. Basically, no, I don't think we're gonna play Oni Plays on. I don't think we're gonna play Oni Plays. Holy fuck, you're all fucking me up. I don't think we're playing Persona on Oni Plays! That's that. I said, ugh. I do, but you know, like, I would love to play more games with Chris in the future. Your device will restart. No, don't do that. Dumb bitch, don't fucking do that. Alright, listen. Real quick, we're going over this shit, bitches. And that's what we're here to do. Tankman head. What I did, you see this layer down here that just has a couple very solid long spans? This was where, you know, I drew each head. And when I listened to the audio, I planned it out. Because, look who it is. He throws his head back. Puts his head down because he's like, you're sexually ambiguous, angry little friend. And then, you know, he turns his head. He's being very snide. He's being condescending and coming up with like a false truth. Because he says, don't you have a school to shoot up? He's being a dick. He knows that Pico saved the school, but he's tormenting him about it because he's a fucking asshole. Tankman, in a way, almost represents all the people who really just don't get it. The Tankman is only out to slander Pico and make him feel like shit to try and get him to go away or to tear him down. So in that sense, the Tankman is like an angry person. You know, he's got like this very condescending like look on his face. Don't you, he's just a jerk. That was completely ad-libbed by Johnny Utah. I didn't have that written in the dialogue at all. When I told Jeff to record this, I said, all right, Pico shows up and the Tank Man is mad about it. And Jeff sent me this thing where the Tank Man's just like, fuck you guys, let's rock. And I'm like, no, no, no. The Tank Man's pissed, Jeff. He's fucking pissed. And so Jeff sent back this shit where he's like, well, 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 look who it is. And then, like, Jeff had that line about the cunts, and he's like, don't use that. And I was like, oh, we're using that. I was like, that's going in the fucking game. And he was like, seriously, don't use that. And then, literally everybody started telling me to stop using it. And Cam was like, I don't know, Dave, should we use that? And I was like, Cam, listen to the audio. And Cam heard it. And he laughed really fucking hard, and he said, we're using that. And I was like, sweet. But basically, yeah, so, like, Jeff helped do the lip sync for these scenes. And we used Jeff's style of doing mouths. So the Jeff style of doing mouths is that, like, Jeff put all the mouths in a single symbol. And what we did was, like, for each mouth on the timeline, we went to properties and we hit single frame, and then we memorized what the mouths were on. Holy shit. The chat's going nuts. We memorized what frame the mouths were on, and we plugged in little numbers. Like, this mouth is 6. Or, like, mouth open like this is 3. Mouth, like, for the O shape is 4. And so, yeah, like, we would just hit single frame and plug in the numbers. Yeah, mouth for the F mouth, that's 8. Holy fuck, the chat's going fucking crazy. Holy shit. Man, this chat's nuts. Here, wait. This is, like, totally fucked. Alright, I have to enable slow chat and then, like, get rid of the penis, message, because this is getting crazy. Man, I wish I knew how to use any of the mod tools at all. I'm so fucking stupid. Slow mode. 120 seconds. Okay, so now we've got slow mode. Now I can actually read what the fucking chat is saying. Okay, now I have to look at how to block a message. Would it even matter? People are just gonna post the same fucking message with less shit. Huh. Hello, you're new? Well, hello, Breath of the Wild fan 333. This chat is crazy. Oh, man. This shit's fucked. I don't even know what to say. This shit's just so fucked. Alright, I'm gonna read donations in a minute. I'm trying to ignore the giant dropping cock and balls in chat, because I just don't fucking know how to do anything about it. Ah! Alright, are there any new grounders in the chat? Oh, this is just all fucked. I don't even know. What the fuck is Newgrounds? I'm a Newgrounder while posting the cock and balls I'm seeking to get rid of. Oh god. Oh fuck. Alright, I'm gonna... This is getting crazy. I gotta just not look at the chat. You gotta understand. Oh shit. I don't even. Oh god. All right. Enough of this shit. We're going back to reviewing. I'm just gonna ignore all the shit that's going on because I don't know what the fuck to do about it. Holy shit. Yeah, we do need a mod. Dave, please get a mod. Listen, I don't know what to do. Sussy said, I use Newgrounds every now and again. Well, that's not what I asked you. Make Ninja Muffin a mod? Is he here? I don't know if he's here. Dave, save us. Help. Get Nightbot. What is that? I'm trying to read these damn comments and like the damn Kagaballs pops up. Oh, you're making me laugh. Everybody's posting the cock and balls. You're being fucking naughty. Alright, okay, I don't know what to do. Dave, we can't take it anymore. Everybody ironically crying for help and making me laugh too. Alright, if you post the cock and balls, you're being banned, I'm sorry. Alright, or at least you're being timed out. Alright. Every cock and balls I see, you're being timed out. I don't know what to, okay. Holy shit. If I see you posting the cock and balls, I'm gonna flip a coin to decide whether I'm gonna time you out or just straight up ban you just for the lulz. Make it follower only. See, I feel like everyone's just gonna mass follow. It won't even do any good. But yeah, I'll do follower only. Alright, we're going follower only for 10 minutes. Oh, goodness. Alright. That actually seemed to help it. Oh, man. That was fucking insane. Oh, fuck. Okay, alright. Back to the review. How long has the stream been going on for? This already feels like it's been like a fucking eternity. We're very far into Mint Electric. Is a Hellbender's cameo planned? Looks like somebody didn't play week 5. Alright, so yeah. Anyway. Now that shit's cleared up. Alright. So here we have the heads, they're like, you know, some of them I animated in here, but I kept that to a minimum. You know, for the most part, I just did the base head movements and put the mouths on top. And, you know, then what I did was each head, once they were already packaged together, I animated them once they were out. So, like, you can kind of see here how... Once I already had the heads bundled together, I made, like, slight movements then. So, like, breaking it up this way, it was so incremental that, like, you know, I was able to manage it. And then the body, I did all on one frame for the most part. I just did, sort of like I did the parents on Christmas, you know, like... I just moved each hand in piece, like, bit by bit, and I kept, like, reference bodies nearby. Do 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 do. The way they slam on the guitar in this song is so good. This album is by the guy who did the Parappa music before he worked for Sony. So yeah, and I just did like a handful of unique hands, like the pointing hand. Hey Dave, guess what? Cock joke. What plugins do I use for Flash? Only one. I use Frames to Symbol, which Corey dug up for me. Corey couldn't believe I didn't use that, and now that he showed it to me, I understand why he felt that way. Frames to Symbol is great. I don't know where to get it. He gave it to me though. Oh, man. This is all just getting so nuts. But thank you. This is fun. Man. I want to do a Camden and play like a multiplayer game with everybody. Wait, this is Flash. That's right. Tetisar 64, it's Flash. You're watching people post cock and balls en masse in a stream about a Flash program. Alright, we're going to read some of these donations. I wish I put donations in a separate category so I could read them easier. Do 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 do. Alright. Fancy Pants Tomato Boy said, donated $10 and said, would you say Tank Man is an angry Joe? You know, I wouldn't say that. But, you know, I do know that, you know, Jeff has been struggling and bedridden due to a similar cause recently, so. I get what you're saying. Let's see. No show. What, man, I don't know how to say your name, dude. No she who all who addle. No she who addle. If I'm saying that right. Donated $1 and said, "Lol, you created something good, and now you have to deal with the consequences." Just my fucking luck. Mr. Cooliosis donated $5 and said, "A while ago, I found a file called C_ZMP3 in the source code art folder and had this signal that it was decoded as some journal writing. I asked Ninja Muffin on Twitter about it, and all he told me was Cyberzone. Any idea what that was about?" Ninja Muffin said it best, Cyberzone. One day you'll know what that means. Davin Adder, Davin Adder, donated $10 and said, please do not feel pressure to work past your limit. Take your time, bro. Release it when it's ready. Saying that it's okay if it would take years. Cheers, King. Well, thank you. I appreciate that. Wanting to get something out sooner than later is, you know, it's partially for the people, but it's partially for myself. Every artist holds themselves to standards. They want to get stuff done. But yeah, to make the game actually moddable, we're working on stuff right now. I mean, dude, let me tell you, I will not show the assets for it because you bastards will just trace it. But the cutscenes are interactive. That's right. When we made the cutscenes, I planned that they would have interactive moments in them. And you'll have to find the interactive moments, just like you would have to find the interactive shit in, like, the old Newgrounds Flash collabs. Like, how if you were watching the Flash collabs, you could, I don't know, in Stamper's short at the end of the Street Fighter collab, you could click Vega's balls and some funny shit would happen. And, you know, like, if you put in, like, the code for a short you can during Tom's short, or whatever, Sagat would uppercut Ryu. Like, there'll be stuff like that in Friday Night Funkin'. I don't want people to just sit around and watch stuff. I want them to find all sorts of weird shit. But all in due time. You'll see what I mean later. Probably more likely, it'll be hard. It'll be difficult for you to find though. Probably more likely than not, you'll find some YouTuber finding it. God damn, that's so loud. Why is it so loud?
Well, what do we got here?
I'm wondering, I think. Pico killing assets. Oh, yeah. Yeah. In here, I have, we have the bloodless versions for the censored one. Their blood becomes blue because it's more like sparks. We're going the Samurai Jack route. And then also, like, I went through the extra effort to take the blood out of his little suit there. But it retains it in the uncensored. So you can turn blood off, just like Alien Hominid. Like I said, Dave, don't censor stuff. Okay, listen. As a kid, I had to turn the blood off an alien hominid when my family members were around, or I would have gotten my ass beat. And if Tom and Dan Paladin didn't put that in the game, I don't know if I'd even be using Newgrounds today, because I would have gotten all my shit taken away from me. So, like, I know I've been tormenting people a little bit, so, like, saying bad stuff on the Kickstarter updates, just for, like, funniness. But, like, you know, when the actual full game is done, I want people to be able to play it without, you know, getting their shit taken away. I got my Pokemon cards taken away as a kid because my parents said that they were satanic. And so, like, I know I joke about, like, getting people in trouble, but I know it feels very sad to have your stuff taken away as a kid. So, I mean, you know, I'm not going to censor the game completely. You'll be able to play it with all the mean stuff that I intend to be in the game, but, like, you know, you'll be able to play this stuff. And it's not that parents are being mean. Sometimes parents see this stuff and they just freak out and they don't understand what it is. And, you know, if there is a parent who literally does not want their kid seeing blood, or if there's, like, some squeamish 19-year-old out there, listen, I don't know. I want to build the tools for people to be able to enjoy the game. And that's just that. At the same time, you see what we're looking at right now? Nice juicy blood. The game's gonna have blood. But you'll be able to turn it off. I think it's a fair compromise. I'm hands down tempted to have this option where if you turn naughtiness on or off, if you turn it off, it says, be sure to mind your P's and Q's. And if you turn naughtiness on, it says, your parents better not hear the game saying fuck. I don't know if you know this, but are the cutscenes in the game MP4s? Yeah, they are MP4s, but they won't be MP4s when they're in the desktop version. Them being MP4s was a quick roundabout way to get the game released sooner since people were dying to play it. But MP4s can't work in the itch version. Anyway, man, this review is getting out of hand. Dave, what will the naughtiness sensor get rid of? So naughtiness will change dialogue that is just, it, like, a little intense. And it will... That's it. Naughtiness will mostly get rid of, like, the dialogue or any issues like that. But then... Like, if I do... Like, let's say I make graphics of characters flipping each other off. Then, like, that would probably be taken off with naughtiness, maybe. But, like... Blood will be a different setting. There's no setting you can enable that will take off the game saying that missing a note is shit. Or, like, you can't turn off the tankman being shot altogether. Basically, when I'm making the censored version, I'll think, what would little Dave have gotten in trouble for playing? What would he have needed to turn off to be able to play this game in front of other people and not have his PS2 smashed into little fucking pieces? And that'll be my metric for as I build that. And of course, you know, if Cam or any of my other friends who I'm making the game with come to me and say, Dave, this should probably be behind, like, we should have a censor option for this. Then I'll do that. What about sex and salads? Ah, shut the fuck up. You can't even see that's in the background. I'm leaving that shit on. This fucking album, man, it gets me every time. How many times have I listened to this shit while streaming? If only I could fucking sing along with it, but hey, being able to dance along is good enough. If you watch my streams, you're gonna get a healthy amount of cringe of me poorly singing along with albums I'm listening to. Why are there two Steves in week 7? Because the Steve face is more like just an armor. You could debatably say that the real Steve isn't even in week 7. Man, I'm spending so much time just answering questions. I kind of wanted to like go over the drawings, guys, the drawings. Boink. The little back of his helmet explodes open, little pieces come out. Glass shatters from the visor. Boink, the blood comes out. The blood comes out different from the pieces in the back. The gun spins around. And the gun starts to fall down. And they blink away like arcade characters, which sort of brings a little bit of levity to the gruesomeness of it. One guy wrote Pico Made with a question mark in the chat. Some Friday Night Funkin fans are just the most, like, I don't know. Sometimes when people write something, I just wonder, like, what's going through their brain. And it's like, I just imagine, like, they're walking up to me without, like, any thought. And it's, like, the most innocent and pure thing in the world. They just, like, they just say whatever the first thing on their head is. They say, like, Pico Made to me. And, like, I just put my hand on their shoulder and I shed a single tear. I'm just like, yeah, that's right, little guy. Pico Made. That's right, little buddy. Don't worry. Don't worry, little guy. Pico Made. It's like, I don't know what the fuck you're saying to me, but okay. Anyway, Bench Lasagna donated $2 to Hey Phantom Arcade. You're so awesome, Sauce. It'd be really cool if you said Fromage. Famage? I don't know what the hell that word is. Maybe it's like the omelette du fromage from Dexter. Fravia22 donated $1 and said, has the Naughty Dice node actually changed anything? Well, it's not implemented right now, so no. Because I played it with it off, but it still said cunt. And I was just so sad that I couldn't play it for my family-friendly stream. Yeah, sorry about that. That'll come later. I was gonna say, what the hell? This isn't Mint Electric. This is a different album. Ugh. The Hellbenders have a cameo in week 5. Alright, listen. Will Homestuck Dave Strider get a week? No. Definitely not. Here I made a little grid to help Cam with placing the assets in the game. Here's Pico shooting his stuff. The blasts were originally yellow, but that it was so dumb. They didn't show up on the background at all. So I made them blue. I think it looks pretty good. This face I drew Pico with is like my favorite face I've drawn in almost like anything. Actually, like, I kind of don't like looking at the original Pico models now because I like this face so much. Yeah, and this gun is just a... It's a 3-frame loop. What's on this layer? Oh, the hand. Yeah, yeah. So I just did a frame by frame of the gun. It goes by in just 3. And then the hand is just 1 drawing. But I just positioned how it is. He doesn't have a full finger underneath. No! Because it's hidden by the gun. So, like, the hand just does that thing. Everybody's spun something around on their finger before. So you all know what this is, you know. He's just giving it that twirl and keeping it, like, in motion. He uses, like, the recoil from it shooting back to kind of keep it twirling. Yeah. Here we can kind of see he aims the gun. It's the same arm and hand and gun. This little pop blue doesn't even move, really.
And then, yeah, bang, it pulls back and it leaves like a blue streak from where it fired. You made the gun a movie clip? No, the gun is a graphic. But this little blast is a movie clip because it's blurred and stretched and given an additive. What program is this in? Flash CS4, the greatest program of all time. And then, then we'll go into this. So this, there's his one finger is a symbol because it goes through the holster. Then there's the smears that give the gun sort of like the twirling motion. There's the gun itself, which is just one symbol that's moving around a bit. Then there's the hand in the background that kind of just has that little motion. I can't even see, you can see, the lighting on the palm when the gun is up, yeah. The week 7 censored cutscene pieces. Man, censoring this was really hard. In the full version of the game, if you look, his brains are all out. So, censoring the brains for this was quite the task. Yeah, it's tough to even see because it goes off the screen, but yeah, then, let's zoom out here. Yeah, there's a lot of detail that kind of doesn't make it into the final game because, there sort of is some debris and damage. We'll frame by frame this. So the bullet shoots through his head and it hits the ground before Steve can barely even react. So, right down here, you can kind of see the bullet hitting the ground as well as, the general impact flying off. Who did the scream for him? That was Chris O'Neill. That's Oni. He gave me that scream. It's from his FF7 Let's Play. I use it in some of my stuff sometimes because it's so funny. So then the bullet travels faster than the body. It hits the ground. And once again, I don't know how this shit really works in real life. I just kind of made up my own physics for it. Then the body hits the ground. Pico's gun recoils after that. But I think actually if it was real, the gun wouldn't recoil. The gun would recoil as the bullet leaves the chamber. But anyway, bullet leaves the chamber. The gun pulls back. The body hits the ground. The gun goes flying in the air. So then Steve's body, now hitting the ground, slams against the ground with super force. And that causes his body to go up in the air a bit. Then he falls back down and splats onto the ground, and his gun falls down and hits him right in the chest. In the full normal version, he coughs up some blood from that. These will be the censored cutscenes that you'll see in the naughty one. Then this isn't in the game right now. There's Pico's supposed to go into this idol during the cutscene. He's just hanging out while John's talking. There you go, guys. You like tracing stuff? There's some nice Pico frames to trace. Okay, Aegis donated 127 and said, "Hey, Phantom Arcade, I love you, pal. What program do you recommend for someone wanting to get into animating?" Flash CS4 or any version of Flash you can get your hands on. It's pretty good stuff. Nothing works quite as well as it. Mr. Fever 808 donated a dollar and said, "When do we get Mommy Mirror's full tit? It's too powerful, can't handle it." Slyther said, "Are you aiming for a T or M rating?" They donated $1. We're not aiming for any particular rating. We're just going to make the game we want to make. And if at the end of the day, Nintendo or somebody says that we can't put the game on the console because it's too violent, we'll just keep dumbing it down with sensors until they let it on while trying to take out as little as possible. Is Quiesprite secretly Chucky Finster? What took you so long to figure it out? Is there going to be a Pico Day celebration type week? guys are so wacky. All right. Woo! Listen, I'm realizing that there's a lot of fucking shit to cover in this. This is meant to be a really short stream. I think I'm just gonna have to do like multiple streams to really cover all this. Week 7 kind of has a lot of stuff. Ooh, okay. Before we sign this off, because we're gonna review more of this shit. I want to make sure that I make a lot of this stuff clear for animators, because I want this to be for fans and animators who want to learn stuff. Okay. So we're gonna do lore real quick, and we're gonna make it pretty short here. So this will all be in cutscenes later. I'm not gonna spoil anything too much. There's supposed to be a week that comes before week 7. As I'm drafting the story, I made a week that comes before week 7 that we haven't been able to do yet. And then from the events of that week, week 7 would happen. The general gist of the story that comes before week 7 is, I won't say who the enemy is or what happens, but the father tricks the boyfriend into taking like a flight. Like, after a while, the parents are amicable with the boyfriend and girlfriend. You know, keep your friends close, your enemies closer. The parents sort of pretend to be nice to him so they can torment him in more close proximity. They tell him that, you know, here, we'll let you take our daughter on a little vacation. They get him on a plane. And then I won't go over what happens. It goes pretty wrong. They fuck him over pretty bad. But as usual, their plans don't quite work out. And the boyfriend and girlfriend sort of fall from the plane. The parents knew that wouldn't be a problem for girlfriend. And they land in the desert. And, you know, the parents had no idea that they would land in the military zone. But they're there by chance. So then they find the tank men, and the tank men are just like, this is like restricted military space. We should kill you. But we're bored. At the same time, you know, I think that the story I'm sort of envisioning is that, like, the boyfriend and girlfriend, like, had, like, trackers on them. And I, like, the parents wanted confirmation of the bodies. Well, body, you know, they knew the girlfriend would be fine. Their daughter. So Pico's out there. He's supposed to get the boyfriend's body. But, like, you know, instead of confirming his corpse, he fucks up his job again. And does not, you know, complete his hit on the boyfriend. And, you know, that's not going to bode well for him. He's in deep shit for that now. So that's that. That was a bit of a dump. I feel like that was a good one.
And who knows? Maybe I'll rewrite it and change it a little later. Just to spite you fuckers.
But, yeah, that's that. I'm not gonna say any more than that, because I feel like that's already a shitload. And I don't want to tell the whole story before I have cutscenes like done. But yeah, Pico, you had one job. I mean, the funny thing is, as you can surmise just by the gate, I don't know. You know, it's like Pico didn't even really need to help them out. They kind of had it covered. I did like seeing the theory that some people say the girlfriend summoned Pico in. That was interesting to see when the game first came out. So yes.
Trying to like read the chat. It's moving so fast. It's tough to digest. Mike Hawk donated $1 and said Newgrounds, more like Poo Grounds. You fucking bastard. Man, this album we're listening to is just like magical. What a magical backdrop. Is Flash the S4 free? The chat can answer that one. How's Isaac's butthole? It's in bad shape, dude. It's looking like he's gonna have to do those erect mode songs. Brain shutting down. I think my streams are gonna have to get shorter because I feel like my brain can only speaking directly to the chat, my brain can only last like so long. Hey Phantom, what's stopping me from saying Bebo Boppy? Nothing. You can say it anytime you want. The most controversial statement in the world. Lively Tino said Bebo Boppy, holding his fist in the air while a crowd of millions watched. Hatsune Miku week? I fucking wish. Blah, blah, blah. No way. Redacted leaks. No! I had so much fun making all this stuff. It was very stressful, though. But it was fun. Originally, too, in that, like, thing that I accidentally leaked. Here's the thing. Everybody said that I leaked it on purpose. Listen, assholes. I was screen capping the damn thing to send it to Cam and everybody to show them what I'm working on. And then, you know, I was watching that Sony stream, and I pulled up my screen cops. Did I just say screen cops? Because I looked at the guy say nightmare cops. I pulled up my screen cap to screen cap something on the stream. But unknowingly, I had the damn week 7 in there. And when I did that, oh, I just couldn't believe it. I felt like the dumbest motherfucker on the whole planet. And then, like, it's so stupid. People couldn't even believe it. People are coming up with conspiracies. I was doing it on purpose. Because honestly, everybody just has so much faith in me, they don't think I could possibly be that fucking stupid. And you know what? I appreciate that people want to come up with excuses for me, but no. I am just that dumb. Sorry. It probably won't be the last time it happens. But we're trying to not leak everything. Skittles is just watching shit go down. What would erect difficulty be like? Good question. Erect difficulty would be the song you know and love, but remixed to be faster. A problem with the game is, how do you add more notes to a song where the notes, Quiet Sprite donated $5 that don't leak week 8. I don't even know if that's a real Quiet Sprite, but trust me, bro, I won't. I almost opened the week 8 files when I started this stream, but I didn't. Anyway, listen. So, with erect difficulty, how do we add more notes to the song? We can't. Because, you know, bop, beep, bo, bop, beep, bo, bop, beep, bo, bop, beep, that's it. Those are the notes. The song is the notes. You can't add extra notes in between that because those notes don't exist. They're the song. And so, like, that tormented me, that, like, hard mode is essentially, like, normal, basically, because that, you know, has all the notes for the song, but that's as hard as it can get. And so people say, like, the game's too easy. It's disappointing me. And, you know, I love Project Diva. I love unlocking the extreme difficulty after playing hard mode, and I like that extreme is closer to the full song, but we can't do that. So what's the solution here? We're building a game. How do we get a harder song out of the thing? Well, remixing it. Isaac likes to remix songs. He made an amazing fresh remix that a lot of people have heard. Like,
if Isaac remixes the songs to be similar, they're still the songs that people love, but they're crazier, they're more intense, like, they have double, in some cases, maybe even the notes. Because there could be, like, erect and erect extreme, where, like, if Isaac makes a crazy strong, crazy song, then maybe there could be even be two versions of the erect that don't put in all the notes. But, you know, and then for the occasion of erect mode, since Isaac is, like, basically gonna have to remake every single song in the whole game, for the occasion, I want to make spruced up art that feels as spruced up and as cool as the music that will be new. So every week we'll get like a new fresh coat of paint. It's not just going to be that things are recolored. It's going to be more like things will gain unique properties. I mean, in a way, we still have to, like, that's the general pitch. Remake all the songs in the game and make the art better. As to how much more exactly comes out of that, if erect mode even has two difficulties associated to it, because the normal erect would be too difficult, exactly what the art is, if there's a story tied to it or, like, a reason. Now, somebody there said it doubles the work. See, it doesn't double the work. It doubles the content, but the thing is that, like, if I already have the base art as a foundation and Isaac has the base songs as a foundation, it will be a stupid amount of work. But there's something to build off of already. The core has been built. So, like, I think it's doable. I think it's possible. Even if, like, we have to just hire insane amounts of help, it's possible. And How the hell can I make a rhythm game? How can I be a Project Diva fan and not have a fucking extreme difficulty? How can I do that? I'd be making a worse game than other games that came before. If we're really making the best rhythm game we can make, we should be trying to shoot above things that have come before us. And having an extreme difficulty, a difficulty past hard mode, it's one of the basics, but the only way we can do it right, the only way we can do it well, doing it this way, the long way, the hard way. Anyway, that turned into like a tangent. That was like an emotional speech. All right, listen, I'm already fucking tuckered out. I don't know if you've answered this already, but will other weeks be fully voice acted? Full voice acting is for the characters that can speak English. There's Pico in his balls again. Or just a guy in his balls. Kind of looks like Pico. Big massive one. Donated $1. Said, yes, yes. Take my money. Miss Gogo donated $5 a day. Will Cassandra be in the game at any point? Thank you. I can't answer that. Sorry. Oh, man. I'm imagining that this picture people are posting of the cock and balls that looks like Pico is the, like, is the really old tormented Pico that Jeff drew in that one cartoon where he resolves his trauma by he decides to not kill himself and jerk off instead. Why do you guys keep posting that? Alright, guys. We're gonna have to cover these assets another time. It's been fun as hell playing around with you, Falcon Wacky Bastards. Whoa, somebody just posted that, like, little manga bird. What the fuck is his name? I forget. If I didn't read any donations, sorry. I thought I caught them all. We will go over more of the Week 7 assets later. We'll play more video games later. Like I said, Week 7's done. It's back to streaming. But listen, right now, Mao Ling, the artist who did Week 6. I'm going to turn off slow mode for a bit. I'm gonna let the dogs out. How do I do that? I'm going to talk to the people the way they want to be spoken to, with pure insanity. Fucking, what the hell? I found that earlier. Moderation settings? What the hell? Oh, man, listen, I wish I wasn't dumb and I knew all this shit worked. Oh no, I don't know how to get back to the chat. Ah, I fucked it all up. Whoa, I don't know how, what the hell I'm doing. I'm fucking everything up. I want to get back to the chat. No! Whoa, literally, what have I fucking done? Okay, wait. Okay, yeah. Okay, so they turned the followers only off. Slow mode's off. Alright. There we go. Back to full insanity. There we go. That's what I like to see. Yeah, look at these bastards. They're fucking losing their minds. You sick wackos. Oh man, I just like, man, I've like totally fucked up everything. I'm like in this one thing, I fucked up all the side stuff. God damn. Shit. Man, I busted this. I can't even open the goddamn chat anymore. Alright, I'm gonna get this working one way or fucking another. Holy shit. How the hell do I fucking... I fucked everything up. No, because of that, we have to watch this shit. Alright, I'm gonna leave this playing while I try and figure this shit out. Oh, there we go. I just have to hit refresh chat. Oh, wow, the chat's going crazy. Wow, you guys are insane. Alright, so wait, how do you raid somebody? It's like slash R, right? Slash, wait. Oh, yeah. All right. So, Mao Ling is streaming. We're gonna go in there. Mao Ling is the artist who, you know, like we directed and like we had make week six assets. So everybody, I want you to go in to Mao Ling's stream. We're gonna raid them. And I want everybody to go in there, and I want them to say, I want you to say that Senpai is sexy. How's that? Senpai is sexy. Or just say, I want to kiss Senpai. There you go. I want to kiss, I like that. I like that. So she's doing some educational thing. Let's just go ruin that. It's her stream's a Senpai stream now. It's wanting to kiss Senpai stream. All right, let's do this. I don't care what she's doing, like a learning thing. Learning sucks. Wanting to kiss Senpai is cool. Alright, guys. Alright. Ready? Let's do it. Woohoo! This is wacky. Mm-hmm.
Senpai is a character from Friday Night Funkin that I had the honor of draw. Okay.
I'm just gonna own Mo that I recently played Friday Night Funkin and was in awe of senpai and the work.
This is.
Thank you so much.
Sheena, please send this to me. Send me more information.
All right, wait. I think I'm still streaming on mine. Like, you can still watch me. I think that's how this works, right? So I'm just gonna. This beautiful album while watching all this senpai sexy pop up. And the penis messages. You know, sometimes making this game is really stressful. And, you know, we've had a lot of hard times making it. But when I can just see a ton of people post cock and balls in chat and just make life miserable for everyone else, that's just when it all feels worth it, you know? Just seeing a ton of people just spamming really annoying shit. It's just when you really feel like a day has come together. Thank you. Thank you all for supporting Friday Night Funkin. I'll be back on stream soon, and I'll make sure that I say the F word a lot, because I just can't help it. Thanks for stopping by, guys. This has been a Phantom Arcade stream. Bye-bye. Bye, guys.